Every time you plan a road trip, you get excited. But how many of you have faced the difficulty in planning? I'm not talking about the weekend ride that you guys go out on every weekend with 100 to 300 kilometers ride and get back home in the evening and you're all done. No, I'm not talking about that. What I'm talking about is at least 5 to 10 days of ride plan. When you're planning these multiple day rides, there'll be a lot of things that you will have to keep in mind, like logistics, like your destinations, which routes you're going to take, and your food expenses, miscellaneous, and everything. Apart from this, the most important thing is you need to get those many days out of your regular life. You need to take leave from your office if you're working out of office. You need to take time out of your business if you're a businessman. Last but not the least, it's all about how much budget you're going to finish this trip in. Usually this happens, your friend is going to come up with a plan and he'll tell, bro, let's go on this awesome ride trip for 5 days. You'll be all excited and you will tell, yes, let's do it, but bro, how much is the budget? He will just blindly tell, bro, you can finish it off in 10,000 bucks. But once you go on that trip, then only you will know that you have made a big mistake in your budgeting. You end up spending 15,000, 20,000 or 25,000 or even more. We never know, right? So welcome back to the channel, guys. Hope you all are having a fantastic day. And today I'm going to show you how to plan your road trip and budget each and every element of your trip properly. So all you'll have to do is watch this entire video till the end to understand how each and everything is calculated and come up with the right budget for your trip. So me and my friends had this awesome road trip planned from Bangalore to Kanyakumari. So you guys might think that Bangalore to Kanyakumari, you can do it in like 1 or 2 days and get back in 1 or 2 days. So that's not what we had in mind. What we were thinking of is covering about 5 to 6 destinations in about a week's time is what we had thought of, but we hadn't done any planning or any budgeting for this trip. So I think even they will be surprised by looking at this video. So when it's a 5 to 7 days of riding and roaming around, there'll be a lot of expenses that needs to be taken care of, and also getting leaves out of your regular life is a little difficult. If people are passionate about what they're doing and they need that time out of their regular life, they'll definitely get it for sure. So what we're going to do now is we'll go one by one. We'll see what are the destinations that we're going to cover and how many days it's going to take, how many kilometers that we are going to cover to reach all these destinations, and then we will see what's the fuel cost. And I'll try and do it as we speak. I'll try to record the screen. I'll put it somewhere here so that you guys can take a look while I'm doing it right now. So let's start looking at the destinations that we're going to cover. So I'm opening Google Maps right now. Let me open this, and we'll be starting from Bangalore, because this is where I'm based out of, and we will have to start from Bangalore. Right, so the first destination that we have thought of visiting is Coimbatore. So let's see how we are going to do this. So Coimbatore is about 312 kilometers, and okay, 1 second, guys. Okay, I have something to improvise here. So going to Coimbatore directly on that day will not help, because the place will not help. So we want this ride to be a little more interesting and relaxed, because we might be going out after a very long time. So riding on the first day for 300 kilometers, we can pretty much do it, but what I can do here is add another stop in between Coimbatore and Bangalore. So what we'll do is we will just include Ooty. So why I chose this is because Ooty is a very beautiful place, and the ride is going to be so relaxing. There's a lot of ghat section and greenery where you're going to enjoy the ride really, really well. So I think we'll have to stay back in Ooty after 7 hours of riding. So yeah, we'll be staying there. That will be our destination number one. And 7 hours and 290 kilometers is what I'll just make a note of this so that I can put it on the display while calculating the entire trip budget. Okay, Okay, the next one would be from, we'll just put Ooty here, and from Ooty we will have to go to, so it's from Ooty to Coimbatore, right? So Ooty to Coimbatore is not far. See, what I'm talking about is this. Ooty to Coimbatore is an amazing route because this stretch over here, it passes through Koonur. Koonur is again a very, very famous hill station. Not as famous as Ooty, but the scenery over here is really amazing. We will have to pass through this. So on that day, we will come to Coimbatore. It's not much. It's 2 hours, 3 hours of a ride. But if we want to, if we don't want to stay in Coimbatore, the next destination will be Madurai. Okay, so we need to visit few places in Coimbatore, and in total it's gonna take about 7 hours to Madurai. I don't think so that we can do this. We just don't want to strain a lot. We wanted to, as I already told, we wanted to be a very relaxing ride. So we I think we will stay in Coimbatore on the second day. On the second day. So I'll just note this down. 85 kilometers and about 3 hours. 85 kilometers and about 3 hours. All right, we are done with the destination three. Over here, let's move on to the next one. So for all these places, what places you'll have to visit and how are you going to plan all of that, I will tell you in a bit. You'll have to just watch the entire video. Next would be, sorry, from Coimbatore to Madurai. Okay, this is one good ride. It's 218 kilometers and about 4.5 hours. Okay, we will have to stay there. It's about 5 hours of ride, 4.5 to 5 hours of ride. Let's go to the next one. Madurai to, it is Rameswaram. Rameswaram, yeah. Sorry if I have pronounced it wrong. Rameswaram is 173 kilometers and 3.5 hours of ride. The next one will be our final destination. That is Kanyakumari. Right, we will look into this. Nice, this is a 300 kilometer nice ride. Sometime across the coastal line, this is interesting. And we will pass through Tirunelveli also. This is also a well-known place here. If we get time, we might stop and, you know, while taking a break, we can visit one or two places, one or two hotspots in that city. Yeah, let's make a note of this, 309. So, okay, lastly, it's time after Kanyakumari to head back home. So we won't be doing, as I said, it'll be a relaxing ride. We won't be doing Kanyakumari to Bangalore in one single day. We're going to take a stop in Madurai. 245 kilometers and about 4 hours, 12 minutes, 4 hours, 4.5 hours. The next one will be Madurai to Bangalore. This is good one. 436 kilometers and 7 hours 21 minutes of a ride. This is going to be a full day's ride. Okay, so now we know the total number of kilometers that we'll be covering during this entire ride, but you will have to add about 10 to 15% more kilometers to the total kilometers that you'll be covering. Let me tell you why. This is done because once you reach any destinations, you'll be visiting different places, maybe covering 5 kilometers, 6 kilometers to go to different places and visit them. Also, while going on the highway, you might encounter road constructions, and there might be a case where you'll have to take diversions and it might cost you more kilometers. So this 10 to 15% should be added. So what I see here is the total is coming up to 1756. If we add about 10 to 15%, the total figure would be about 2000 kilometers. It's a 2000 kilometer ride, guys. I don't know when we are going to execute this, but this is really exciting. Okay, so now calculating the fuel cost. 2000 kilometers, my bike gives an average of 20 to 22 on a highway and about 14 to 15 in a city. Oh, by the way, I didn't tell you about my bike. I ride a Kawasaki Z900. That's why the mileage is like that. I mean, it's a decent mileage for a 948cc inline 4 bike. It's got a lot of power and giving about 22 kilometers per liter on a highway. It's good. It's good for me actually. So I've taken the average mileage as about 18 kilometers per liter. So 2000 divided by 18, it will give you somewhere around 111 liters of petrol that you would need. So now the cost of petrol is about 85 rupees. If you multiply them, it's 9500 for fuel. So say if you have a smaller CC bike and your bike gives a mileage of about 30 to 35, then the fuel cost will be somewhere around 4500 rupees, which is a decent amount for 2000 kilometer, right? So now we are finished with calculating the fuel expenses, which came up to 9500 for me. The next element that we're going to see is about the accommodation in each of these destinations. In total, we have about 6 destinations where we are going to stay. Apart from the last day when we are getting back to Bangalore, then we'll be at home. We don't need any accommodation, paid accommodation at least. Let me show how I'm going to search for accommodation. So first is Ooty accommodation. So what I'll do is I'll just go to this page is actually very informative and it helps a lot. So I've just selected the day when we are going to arrive in Ooty, and this is tentative. I just put some random date. So it will be a twin sharing basis, so it's for 2 guests, and we are trying to cap the expense somewhere below 3000. Okay, so below 3000, what all do you need? Rating, it should be somewhere at least 3-star to be a decent hotel, and amenities, it's good if we have free Wi-Fi. Free breakfast is important here early in the morning. I seriously don't like to go out and search for breakfast. We'll be so tired and we'll be in a hurry going to the next destination. So free breakfast, okay. Free parking. Parking is very important because you'll be relying on your motorcycle for a number of days. And if somebody does something to your bike and it's really bad, it'll cost you a lot of time. And it's very frustrating also. So free parking. If it has restaurants and room service, it's good. So let me apply this, put free cancellation on as well. So okay, so looking at this, there are quite a few hotels which come at this cost. So what I see here is on an average 2500 is what it might cost for 2 people. So for one, it will cost 1250. Okay. Similar way, do it for all the destinations. So we are done with searching all the hotels for different destinations, and these are the prices that I've come across. I just put it on the screen. You guys can take a look at it. So the next thing that we're going to see is what are the tourist attractions in these places where we are traveling. So you should be ready with at least 3 places to visit at each of these destinations if you have time. So you should not be like, you know, I have 1 hour, I need to sit and search and I don't know where to go and waste some time. So instead, you can have at least 3 places ready. If you have 1 or 2 hours, you can go to 1 or 2 places. If you have more time, you can visit more places. So let's go ahead and search for different attractions in these destinations which we are traveling. So again, we'll use the same Google page. Here we have seen the hotels. If you see here things to do, you can just go there, and the first thing is Dubai. Let's quickly do this. So for Rameshwaram, when you search for Rameshwaram, there is one place which is not there here, that is the tip. This is called Dhanushkodi. I think we'll have to include this in the list. Okay, we have successfully done this. We have the list of 3 places for each destinations, so that if we have time when we reach, each of these destinations, we'll definitely do it. Either the day we reach or the very next day when we are leaving from that place, we can do this. By the way, when you are visiting places, guys, please keep in mind that you're traveling on your motorcycle and you'll be having luggage with you, right? These places being tourist spots, there'll be a lot of thefts and people who can easily cheat you. So should be very careful while you're parking your bikes and leaving the luggage. So it's always suggested that drop your luggage in the hotel and visit all these places, then get back and then you can leave from that place. Carrying all the luggage to these places will not be okay. And other thing is that all these places will have their own opening and closing timings, which you need to keep in mind. You need to keep in mind the amount of entry fee that they're going to charge. Some places will be closed for 1 or 2 days in a week. That also should be considered while you are shortlisting the places that you want to visit. Okay, now we saw the fuel expenses, we saw the accommodation prices, and we just saw what are the places that we can probably visit if we have more time. Now it's food time. So for food, I think for these places where we have shortlisted, they already are providing free breakfast, so the breakfast part is sorted. Apart from this, you might have to spend for lunch and dinner. I think 200 to 300 rupees per meal is sufficient. Apart from this, you should also have a little budget for your snacks as well, where you'll be having some protein bars to keep your energy level up and some energy drinks like Red Bull or something, right? So I've kept about 1000 rupees per day, which is a little on the higher side, but it's good always to plan on the higher side rather than the lower side, and end of the day you were not happy in spending more money. So 1000 rupees is for one day is what I've planned. Have I missed out on anything? I don't think so. If you guys feel I've missed out on something, please do let me know in the comment section below. I would be happy to, consider those points as well. Last but also important one is the buffer money that you're going to plan. That will be about 3 to 5,000 rupees. This is important because while you're riding, if your bike needs some kind of small maintenance or a small checkup service, so this amount will be handy for you. Okay, now let's quickly sum up everything together. So fuel 9,500, accommodation about 7,000, food 7,000, sightseeing I've put 1,000 bucks if there is any entry fees. I saw a couple of places where they charge entry fees per person, so 1,000 bucks there. And this is the extra buffer money, miscellaneous money that I've put in. 30,000 trip budget. We just blindly thought that this is gonna be done in about 15 to 20,000, but 30,000. Yeah, 30,000 it is. We just successfully calculated the trip budget, which is completely out of my budget right now. Maybe in another couple of months we'll be able to save some money and bring up the budget to this mark. See, this is why it is important to calculate your trip properly. Put in every single aspect and then only tell people that this is what it's gonna cost. Also, there are a few things which we didn't calculate while budgeting for this trip, is because these are generic items that you might already have, or you should have to buy it for once and don't invest in every other trip that you go on. Okay, a few things like bike service you get it done regularly, and it's different for each of the bikes, so we didn't consider that part. And also you should have a proper toolkit for your bike, and also a medikit, couple of medikits, 1 or 2 medikits for the entire group will be sufficient. Okay, one last step before I close this video is, once you reach the room in each of the destination, you'll be extremely tired and your body will be cramping like hell. So to get rid of this and feel more relaxed the very next day, what you should do is spend 5 minutes of your time to stretch your body before going to bed. This will help you a lot. Next day morning, you will feel much more relaxed, and it works. It works, guys. Trust me on this. Try it once and you will do it. So guys, thanks for watching the video till here. I hope you guys have liked this video. Go ahead, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit that like button. We will see much more videos like this. Stay connected. Have a good day. Bye-bye.